The Godox TT600 budget flash is one of a few budget flashes that is high-speed sync capable. Now, why is that important and what is high-speed sync? Well, let me demonstrate. If I want to take a picture and I connect this flash onto this Canon and I set my shutter speed above what is called the flash sync speed, I'm going to start having problems with my picture. So in this case, my camera is set to a shutter of 1 over 350th of a second. And when I take a picture, you can see at the top there, you start getting some black banding. And if I increase the shutter speed even more, so let me go up to, let's say, 1 over 1000th, and I take a picture. And this is the problem that high-speed sync tries to solve. So whenever you want to shoot above the flash sync speed of, for most cameras, around 1 over 200th of a second or 1 over 250th of a second, you need to go into high-speed sync mode. And the thing about the Godox TT600, like I said, it is high-speed sync capable. And all I need to do is go onto this third button and press it, long press it, until this H appears on my screen. So now that it is in high speed sync mode, I should be able to take a picture and not get that banding. But unfortunately, I'm still getting that banding and my flash is in high speed sync mode. What's the problem? Well, the problem is because this flash is a universal flash. When you look at the bottom of the flash, you can see that there's only one pin, one contact pin at the bottom. And that contact pin is there to communicate when the flash should go off when the shutter is pressed. It does not communicate any other information. To solve the problem, what you need is a flash trigger that is compatible with both your flash and your camera. So if you look at the bottom of this trigger, it has multiple pins. And it's also written the X-Pro2C. The C means that it's compatible with the Canon camera system. To get this trigger into high-speed sync mode is very simple. You just go onto the second item right there at the front and you press that and it toggles between high-speed sync and some other sync modes. So all you want to do is press it once and it's now in high-speed sync mode. As long as your trigger is communicating with your Speedlite, the high-speed sync mode is turned on automatically by your trigger. And so now we still have the same settings. My shutter speed is at 1 over 1000 and I take the same photo that I took before. Now my trigger is in high-speed sync mode and I take that photo and the banding is now gone. The flash is now in high-speed sync mode and I can shoot above the flash sync speed. And that's how you shoot in high-speed sync mode using the Godox TT600. You need a trigger on top of your camera that is compatible with your camera so that the camera communicates the high-speed sync information to your trigger and that information is relayed onto your Godox TT600 wirelessly by the trigger.